What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over the LocketteX plugin and how to use it. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Hosting Minecraft servers opens the doorway for potential issues, like griefers or thieves. You can always ban them, but it's hard to catch everyone on time. And if you want a way to protect you and your players from losing items, then chest protection is a great way to do that. Luckily, LocketteX is here to help, since it can lock chests so nobody can get in and steal or destroy your items. The best part about it is that using it in-game is super easy, since you only need a sign to protect your chest. It'll automatically assign the player to the container, rejecting anyone else from opening or accessing it. Of course, there are ways to change this and add players, so let's go over how to install and use this plugin. Head to the LocketteX spigot page and press download now, and then save this file to a safe location for later, like a separate folder. Head towards your Apex server panel and stop the server. Scroll down to the game files section and make sure you're running a plugin compatible server like Paper or Spigot, and that it is in between the versions of 1.12 and 1.19, since that is what this plugin has been tested for. After that, near the top left, you can click on FTP file access and log in. Head into the plugins directory, and on the next page, press upload and then drag the jar file in. Once it's uploaded completely, you can return to the main panel page and restart the server. After that, join your server and run the /plugins command, making sure to see the green LocketteX. While using LocketteX on your Minecraft server is super easy in-game, you will have to configure a few things before you can start using it. Don't worry though, because it's actually really simple compared to other spigot options. Head back into your FTP file access, log in, and then go back into the plugins folder. Find and enter the LocketteX folder, and then press edit to the right-hand side of the config.yml file. Inside of this file, you're going to want to change the enabled worlds values to match your current one. Additionally, a bit further down, make sure to edit the owner line to just say %owner%. You can look through the rest of the settings to change anything else that you might want, and then you can save the file and head back to the main panel page to restart the server. Join your Minecraft server and find or place the chests that you want to protect. Next, just craft a sign and then shift and right-click the chest while holding it. Enter protect in brackets or your custom sign ID value from the config file. After typing this on the first line, you can press done at the bottom, and your chest is now protected, and you should see a message in the bottom left corner. Since you can use the sign to protect chests, there really isn't a need to set up permissions since players won't need commands to set them. But if you do want to have one, you can use a plugin like Luck Perms. Otherwise, you can just make yourself a server operator to use them. Here is a list of the commands, how to use them, and what they'll do for you in-game. If LocketteX appears as red or doesn't show up after using the plugins command in-game, then you'll want to double-check that the server version supports plugins. You'll also want to check and make sure you're running one of the tested versions, which is between 1.12 and 1.19. Finally, make sure to double-check that the file is uploaded correctly into the plugins file. If you aren't able to save changes in the config file, make sure that your formatting is correct. If you make and save an invalid option, then it'll appear as nothing happened or that nothing changed. If something is formatted wrong, you'll usually see a red X on the left-hand side to give you a warning. Once you fix any formatting errors, resave the file and make sure to restart the server. With public servers comes public disturbances. And if you want to keep your players safe from thieves or griefers, then LocketteX is a great plugin to protect them and their items. make sure to check out the LocketteX spigot page for a more in-depth list of some of the things you can change in the config file, like adding players to chests or a single right-click and protect feature. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.